What would you do if you felt depressed and completely alone? Where would you go to find hope?
What would you do if you lost everything in a sweeping fire and you had nowhere to stay or no clothes to wear?
What if you suddenly lost your job and could not provide for your family food or clothes?
What if you needed to learn a new skill in order to improve the quality of life for your family? Where would you go?
Where would you go?
Where would you go?
What if you just needed someone to talk to? Where would you go to find hope?
To find hope.
To find hope.
To find hope.
We tell the story of the Hope Center in three parts. It's about compassion, community, and the next generation. As this economy has taught so many of us, you never know when it will be your family that needs a helping hand, that needs support. And it's not that people need a crutch or that they need a handout. They need someone or some place to partner with them as they build their future for their family and come out of difficult seasons. This community has seen hardship, just like the rest of the country and the rest of the state. There are people who've lost their jobs or who have become ill or who have faced a tragedy through fire or other unforeseen circumstances. And we as a community can come around those people in places like the clothes closet or the family-to-family furniture bank or the personal needs pantry or the emergency assistance program or any other opportunity that the Hope Center will provide. And we can be the hands and feet of Jesus that help people move from one place to the next. And then they, those same people, become partners for the next family that comes through that might need to visit and get warm coats from the clothes closet. Maybe they need a couch, a place to spend time as a family in a living room. Or maybe it's shampoo or personal items, the things that help you get that next job. Maybe it's time in the computer lab with a tutor or someone who can help with job training. The Hope Center provides those moments and those opportunities. But more than just the stuff and the meeting of the physical needs, it's a place where people can come together, live life, and grow and move on to the next thing. So much of our community and the sense of belonging and being part of a community here in Marysville is dependent on your ability to connect to other human beings, to build relationships and a network of people who support you during the good times and bad. And a lot of what we'll do at the Hope Center is just provide space and place for relationships and community building to happen. You'll find people at the Hope Center sharing a cup of coffee in the cafe, Esperanza Cafe, or you may visit a support group, or you may spend time in the youth center with the next generation that's coming up in our community and needs that context of relationship to feel safe and secure. One of the primary reasons the Hope Center exists is to provide a place of hope for the next generation. The Refuge Youth Center will provide a place of safety, security, and hope for the next generation. Our young people face unprecedented challenges. Drug addiction is run rampant. Their lives are at risk. They face the challenges of suicide. They lose their friends. They often don't know what it is that the future looks like for them. And when caring adults take time to invest in who they are, to show them a way, to build them up from the inside out, and just have fun with them, we make a way for the next generation to live lives of hope.
What if you were blessed and wanted to bless others? Where could you go to give hope?
One of the best ways that a person can invest in their community is to learn to give back. Often we find that the very people who need to be served or helped on the compassion side of who we are at the Hope Center become the very people who can turn around and make investments in other families and in other difficult situations. They can give hope to those who come after them. For many of us, we may not need new clothes from the clothes closet, or we may be able to buy our own fancy name brand shampoos. And we have an opportunity to grow spiritually and to grow on the inside by giving of who we are. Our sense of hope can be expanded when we give back the things that have been so graciously given to us. For some, that's financial giving. It's giving hope and sowing a seed into a situation that might not otherwise have hope. For others, it's sharing of our time and our energy, of our emotional resources. It's being a friend to the person who maybe just needs someone to put an arm around them. Everyone has something to give at the Hope Center. Do you have something to give at the Hope Center? Do you have time, energy, smile, an arm to give a hug? Do you have a financial gift that you can make to the Hope Center? Give online today at hopecenterohio.org.
Give hope.
Give hope.
Give hope.